So, this is a 30-minute game. I'm playing on leeches, and I want to explain my thinking process. Yeah, what's important? You always have to fight for the center. Yeah? So, I am putting my pawn in the center, and yeah, black responds by putting a pawn on d5. So I'm controlling e5 and he is controlling e4. Yeah, so now all you have to do is bring your pieces as quickly as possible into the center, yeah, and develop all your pieces into the center. So now he gives up a little bit of his central control, yeah, by capturing out of the center. Yeah, so what do I do? I occupy now the center with my pawns. And I can even now take on c4 with one move. Yeah, my opponent is playing in a Slav way. I mean, the opening name is not important now. Yeah, so I guess I will drop back to e2. I mean, and my opponent, yeah, is I mean he is advancing his pawns on the queen side. Yeah, but he is also creating some weaknesses. Yeah, especially now the c5 square. So he is indicating that he might want to exchange the bishops. Yeah, he can do that. So I will just continue developing. My opponent, yeah, plays f6. Yeah, a natural move would have been knight f6 to attack the center. Yeah, but f6 is doing nothing. Yeah, so let's just castle and develop, bring your king into safety and bring the rook into the game. Okay, so my opponent is showing here maybe some kingside aggression. Yeah, so something like bishop f4 would run into g5. So this is not a good move. Therefore, let me have a quick look. Let's just, yeah, mine, I don't need to make the best moves. Let's just develop and make normal moves. Yeah, now, after 11 moves, all my pieces are into the game. Yeah, I did fight for the center. And black is just neglecting everything. Yeah, so, I mean, he can win a pawn now here on d5. Yeah, he could have won a pawn. Yeah, but I don't care. Yeah, because I'm so much better developed. So now he plays e5. Yeah, and yeah, now I will take on c6. I mean, I'm winning a pawn, but it's not about winning the pawn. It's about, yeah, giving your minor pieces some yeah, some squares. Yeah, they can now invade on the black queen side. Yeah, so and if he, okay, he doesn't do this. Yeah, so now, yeah, man, he is trying to create something here, but it is, yeah, it just doesn't make any sense. This pawn is now of course a strong asset for black. Yeah, I could exchange and give a check. Yeah, but this is why learning your tactics is also very important. Yeah, I mean, if I play the bishop to b5, I'm threatening c7. Yeah, and how does he answer this question? I mean, he can take now. Yeah, but this just develops my rook. Yeah, so, and this is also something important. Yeah, if your opponent wants to exchange pieces, let him exchange pieces on your term. Yeah, if he exchanges your pieces, you should recapture in a way so that your pieces are now more centralized, yeah, so that they work more into the center. Yeah, and this I was kind of hoping for. Yeah, I mean, here black tried to do something here on the king side, and of course, he wants to keep the queens. Yeah, but now with his advanced pawns, he has created weak squares. Yeah, and I can utilize that now by going bishop b6. Yeah, and suddenly the discovered check with c7 is really, really dangerous for black. Yeah, now he does this. So I will give a check now. If he plays bishop d7, yeah, I guess I just would have taken everything on d7, queen takes, yeah, and then give rook d1 check and invade on d8 with the rook. Yeah, so he plays now king f7. So what can I do now? Yeah, I mean, I can just win a full rook by giving queen d5 check. No, the recording was pressed. Yeah, now I'm winning the rook on a8. And yeah, I mean, he doesn't have any threats here at all. I mean, if he pushes one of the pawns, yeah, I can just leave the pawns as they are, yeah? Because I mean, if he can create one threat, I can always parry one threat. Yeah, it is not like you cannot win games, yeah, by just creating only one move threats. Yeah, your pieces have to work together. Yeah, so that you create more threats at the same time. Yeah, and if you put more and more pressure on your opponent, you create more and more threats, yeah, then you will win the game. So right now I'm thinking about, I can even play for some kind of mate. Yeah, with bishop e8, threatening queen f7, and if the king moves, yeah, there would be bishop e3. Yeah, but I can also take the rook, which is the minimalistic, the greedy approach. Yeah, so let me now have a look what he can do against me playing bishop e8. And I don't see something great for him. So let me just do this. Now, as I said, I mean, I could win the rook, yeah, but I mean, yeah, his king is so badly placed, yeah, and this is something, yeah, bishop e8 is a move. I mean, it comes, of course, the stronger you get, yeah, the better your feeling for the initiative and for dynamics for dynamics is. Yeah, the better your feeling for this part of the game is, then you will, yeah, just by pattern recognition, find such moves. Yeah, and my opponent is now really in a deep tank. Yeah, I mean, look how quickly he played so far. Yeah, and this really shouldn't work, because I can give a check now. Yeah, I mean, this is mate. Yeah, but I mean, even if I didn't play Queen f7, yeah, I could take and play h3, for example. Yeah, and with a rook and a queen on h7, yeah, he's not threatening anything. Yeah, I can just ignore it. Yeah, I can, if I wouldn't have this move, I can just keep the position as it is. And if he takes on h2, I go king h1, and if he goes h3, I play g3. Yeah, and his play on the h-file is non-existent. Okay, so now let's deliver mate and have a quick look what happened here in the game. Yeah, so let me make a quick recap. I put my pawns in the center. Yeah, the central squares are the most important squares on the chessboard. My opponent plays a good move. Yeah, I could have played e4 for the French defense. Yeah, but I'm a d4 player. I played c4. Yeah, fighting now for the d5 square, which Black was claiming to control. He plays a d5. Yeah, so this is now the queen's gambit declined. I play knight c3. Yeah, and all my moves are connected to the center. My knight is pressuring d5, is covering e4. Yeah, so I can play e4 maybe if I want. Yeah, so Black took out of the center. And what do? I control. Now I now push my pawns into the center. Now you can also play e3, which is a decent move as well. But I went for the more active one. He played c6. I took. He played b5. I did not do this. Yeah, because I mean, here the bishop is biting on those pawns. Yeah, and it is not clear to me that the bishop is really well placed here. Yeah, and so I dropped back to e2. Why didn't I play bishop d3? Yeah, I mean, yeah, let's say, yeah, you might hope here to create a battery. You might hope to create a battery against the king's side. Yeah, but this is of course a little bit naive, and I wanted to be able to play for d5 at some point. Yeah, and the bishop on d3, is now on the d-file, so my queen is no longer adding to the d5 push. So I wanted, I went back to e2. Yeah, I wanted my bishops here to shine into the black's queen side. Yeah, because he makes his pawn moves there, and every pawn move, as we know, creates some weak squares. So I went bishop e2, b4, I went to a4, having a look on the C5 square. Yeah, and now Black has a backward pawn on the C-file. Yeah, so my knight is actually doing something. Yeah, I mean, it's no longer pointing towards the center. Yeah, but I mean, Black weakened some squares. Yeah, so I'm fine with it. I mean, something like this, or going to here is maybe possible as well. Yeah, but I wanted to play a little bit more forcing. So my opponent went a5. I don't know. Yeah, I was thinking he may try to exchange the bishops. So I develop. Yeah, and if he would have done this, yeah, I will just develop. And if he takes on e2, I say, yeah, thank you. Yeah, because Black is moving his pieces again and again and again. And with every move, I am developing a piece. With every move, I am creating more chances for my pieces. He went f6, of course, a very bad move. I castle, bring the king into safety. Yeah, and here he wanted to create something. Yeah, bishop f4 is not good, yeah, because then it gives him a tempo. Yeah, so this is also an aspect of playing chess. Yeah, you have to always sit down. When your opponent makes a move, take a short break, yeah, and asks, what is his intention? What does he want to do? Yeah, and we don't want to make moves which the black player can create tempi. Yeah, and if bishop f4, he gets tempi. And I have to move the bishop again. So bishop f4 is not good. So I went bishop e3. Now he went g5. Yeah, hoping for his kingside attack. Yeah, and now it is time to open the center. Yeah, and I really don't care. I mean, if he can, somehow win a pawn. Yeah, because, for example, I have knight b6. Yeah, and here I'm winning already material. Yeah, and I can even develop my rooks. Yeah, and they work here on this open file. Yeah, and I mean, this is completely bad, what my opponent is doing. Yeah, all his pieces are sitting at home and they do nothing. Now, they are not developed. When pieces are not developed, they usually don't create any problems for the opponent. So g4, I just went into the center. Yeah, as I said, if he wants to open the position for me, be my guest. Yeah, I can play rook c1, I can play rook e1. I am so much better developed that you don't have to count pawns in this position. So e5, I did win a pawn. Yeah, but as I said, my pieces now are shining into the queen side and I am creating threats. So he played h4, and now I was introducing this c5 discovered check idea. My opponent saw it, so he went queen c7. Yeah, but now, I mean, maybe I could have even done this immediately. No, maybe this is good as well. Yeah, but I give a check. A queen check. Forking king and rook. Yeah, and here I mean I don't have an engine here, but I guess bishop e8 is really just strong. Threatening the check. Yeah, and black can do this to prevent queen f7 check. Yeah, but then I can really just take. Yeah, and as I said, if he does something like this, yeah, I really don't care. Yeah, I mean, even if he pushes here some pawns, he cannot force me to open the h-file. Yeah, and what are his pieces now doing here? Well, so he went g3, and now it was a forced checkmate. Okay, this was a quick video. I hope I can I could explain some things. Yeah, the center is the most important part of the game. Bring all your pieces into the game. If your opponent wants to exchange pieces, do it on your terms. Yeah, if he exchanges your pieces, your recapturing piece has to work towards the center. Yeah, and tactics. I mean, this is of course the most important part in chess. Yeah, so I think if you want to become better, focus on tactics. Don't learn concrete opening theory. Yeah, just play the more developing sound moves. Yeah, and if your opponent makes a move, sit back for a moment and ask yourself, what is his idea? Is he creating a threat? Yeah, and after you realized this, then you can create your own plans and have your own ideas. Yeah, because you always have to respect the opponent's counterplay and the opponent's ideas. Okay, guys, this is just a short video. I hope it helps. Thanks.